time I need to see your face, I just close my eyes. And I am taken to a pursuit of crystal mind. And a gentle feeling, take a chapter in the face of my spine. Straight like a chicken cherry cola. Well, come and stand a little bit closer. Breathe in and get a bit higher. You'll never know what hit you when I get to you.
The offer. Hi, Pia, whatever, you get the idea. How a long time, ain't it? Yes, the college is flesh-melting this semester, but everything is going all right until now. Sorry about the inconsistency of the updates. I promise ye to be more sharp on the updates from now on. Do you wanna know something? I'm changing courses. Yes, I'm not going to study atmospheric sciences anymore. I'm going to be an computer sciences undergraduate. Cool, ain't it? Yeah, don't understand this as a rant against meteorology and all that stuff. It's just that I want to make games. Yep, I'm already studying some C and Flash action script programming languages, and maybe in some months, you will see my first game. I hope the people in the college likes this too, cause I'm having a lot of ideas. Well, this is it. I hope you keep reading, and, just as an extra, I wrote this chapter hearing Mr. Big Green Tenant's Sixted Minds. Is very awesome, isn't it? I'm trying to play it on the guitar, but there are some strange chords. Maybe I'll put it on YouTube. Who knows? Okay, enough diatribes. Enjoy! Offer note 2. This chapter is a bit different from the others in terms of writing, because I wanted to something more, you know, poetic. Just testing my routine, doing experimental stuff. If you liked, tell me. Maybe I write the others like this too.
The Wolfblood Lineage, Chapter 11. Discovering the inner self.
It's a horrible assassination of plans, think Feoxy, utter disdain about the sudden revelation of her newly acquired antagonist. Damn! 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 And Foxy punches the table with so much strong that it breaks in 7 brown pieces of dust. Every honor in the class screams. Ah, Foxy went mad! And despair take cover inside the studnet's body heart. That's what Minerva was expecting. The Dakeyaid witch, now turned zombie, races towards Foxy in the middle of the running confused stwindance, and fastly, like a speed of sound, grabs her wolfless neck.
Yeah. Now you will be dead in me hands, Mr. Foxy.
No! Cries with wolfness groan Foxy. She canvas herself, trying to get free from Minerva's brag hands, but it's uselessness.
Yo-ho, Foxy, you can't escape now. Now, tell me, what's the secret of the Wolfblood?
And the painful scream of agony from Minervok's crotch echoes throughout the classroom, causing students' eardrums to explode in a mass of polycephalic caniceous vomit. The jolts of saccharinic blood fly over the room, washing everyone with bloated intestines. It was with much lucky that Harry Potter, Drago, Ronnie, Luca, Nerval, Hagrid, and Ginny was not in the class at the moment. Everyone affected by the massive collateral shockwaves is turning Inuit a zombie.
No! Cries Foxy. Everyone is turning zombie!
Yar, and you will turn too. You shall serve me inside the sunken Oskland State Reservoir, my battleship.
What? A battleship? This was unexpected. What Minerva is planning? I did the wrong voice and I don't care. Minerva, please say spare us. The students don't deserve such a terrible fate under these ailstorm-covered canvases of passion.
Silence, you ale-spitter. The time you came with your tainted blood inside these walls, you come and demoned all the witches and wizards of the wizard earth. I'm just assuring that after the preposterous battle that will ensue due to your intrusion, I'm going to lead the way into a world of majestic new world order, where witchnesses and wizard will live happily and peace itself out from your warg blood lineage.
And Minerva Froa Fioxy on the ceiling, selling. Vagging her there with a spider web. I don't care about the mispronunciations anymore. Fuck this shit. No, Monieva! You still have salvation! I can take you to the backlight!
No, Foxy. You know that I have no more redemption. Remdepton, after the carcass-inducing poison that Voldemort introduced inside my own veins and flesh, the carnal spawning that afflicted my focal power point put a misery inside my heart.
And a piece of slubbering, rotten piece of meat falls from Minerva's eye, corroding the ground and evaporating like the bludgy and sad pigeons of a cardinal and kite, whatever. She then goes away, taking the student zombies. Godman, I'm an useless. This wolf blood sanguineous anamorphic ataraxy is a curse that I fell no man or woman shall take over its shoulders. Sigh, I wish dead I was at the moment the horse-faced woman my mother she calls herself appeared and discussed the in-betweens of my inner matrix motions. And tears emerge from the very amateurish eye ovoids pulsating latrine or whatever moaning salty water sadness. Foxy Ling cries, exhaling the non-joy of her wolf curse. Myrtle, the moaning ghost, was fallen on the ground, her ears were bleeding, and cotton leeches tried to consume her metaphysical flesh. She was all the time in the room, and the painful, cursed Minerva's screams affected her immensely. The zombification is taking care of her body, and pulsation maggots already are ready to the ghost meat feast before their sensory eyes. Foxy, weeping in the ceiling, looks down, seeing that horrible fnig happening on the ground. No, if Myrtlew turns zombie, all is over. She cannot permit. But she is so sad and weak. She can't do it. She can't. Her wolf blood is not strong to fight enough the battles in the ordinary world. No, Mirla! Don't die! Cries Foixy. No, I must free me from these webs. I must!
And she tries and goes, but useless too. However, from a bang in the buck, Drago Malfoy jumps inside the room, barking and jarring. He looks to Foxy, utterly destroyed in the ceiling, and barks some love dog shouts. Orf! Orf! Foxy looks that,
It's Draco, my love. He wants me to save her. But, Dravo, I can't.
But Docco is not satisfied. He barks more love and with immense full passion. It hits Foxy's cheeks and mouthful lips of brackish mon amour.
Draco, I love much. I fell your love.
The love beat.
The love between us is perpetual. I shall save us all.
And Foxy's body starts to emanate jolts of latiny lights of Mecha World. Yes, the power that was sealed to this moment now arises. Foxy destroys the chains from her webs, obliterating it all. She jumps on the ground with fire emerging from her lips and pulsating blue weasels circulating the now pinky hair she newly acquired in her new transformation. Yes, the first phase in the complete wolf blood transformation is complete. The first circle gate is all broken, and she is powered much more to fight against stranger inner me. Orf! Barks with many happiness Draco, but still advising her to save Meetle.
My Rethel! Utters Foxy. Don't zombie yourself!
And from her completely softful and moaning glory-inducing palms of pleasure, Foxy launches a greenish blast of polyurethanic acid, dissolving the consuming zombification process, washing Myrtle's soul and freeing her from slave labor until global fast food.
What the fuck?
Ah, screams Myrtle, as she is now love-fied from the wolf blood powers. Foxy launches her majestic, powerful feminine body over my Myrtle and hugs her mush. Draco cries, knowing his good deeds will pay in the future, because love is his only goal from now on in the life of discrepancies and sardonic, anthropodermic, droogish fighting tendencies he is now his partisan of.
I am so done.
Oh, moans Myrtle. Fox you saved me. You love me?
Foxy looks deep in the eyes of the ghost and says,
yes, Myrtle, and from now on, I never will let you out of love.
And Foxy approaches her lips to her lips. And then the two girls kisses an absolutely complacentic, marvelous emporium of cherry-flavored fluid-exchanging soda sex. After some moments, Harry Powert, Shiny Whissy, Ronnie Wellesday, Rubius Hazier, Meville Longbottom, Lenua Lovebod, and Carl Johnson, John Hissen enter with them trashed classroom. Harry goes and says to Foxy,
Foxy, we must go now. Minerva plans an attack to the Pentagon. 11th chapter end. There's four more chapters of this. I'm gonna see it through. I don't like it, but I will, because I'm a fucking idiot.